We know that tackling climate change is a global priority. But what can be done about it? A sensible first step is for governments to hold their industries and consumers accountable for the cost of burning fossil fuels. Some governments are already doing this in various ways. But critics say carbon taxes will hurt national economies by making domestic industries less competitive and more expensive. Consumers might purchase cheaper products from countries where carbon taxes don't exist. Worse, domestic producers might relocate their production to countries with lower environmental standards. Consider two toys that look and work the same, but one is made locally with environmentally friendly processes and materials, and the other is very carbon intensive and imported into our market. Should consumers be enticed to purchase the cheaper, dirtier product? How can we encourage industries and consumers to choose products that take the environment into account? One answer is to ensure that imported products pay for their carbon footprint, just like domestic products, through a mechanism known as border carbon adjustments. From a business perspective, these border carbon adjustments would ensure that it's not just domestic producers who need to be accountable for their carbon emissions, but everyone else wishing to access our markets. For the 162 countries who are members of the World Trade Organization, border carbon adjustments have the added bonus of being compatible with countries' international trade obligations. The WTO's predecessor, the General Agreement on Tariffs and Trade, which was signed in 1947, has pushed for the elimination of tariffs in the pursuit of free trade among its members. But the GATT included important clauses for countries to stray from their original commitments in exceptional circumstances. And Clause G of Article 20, as it pertains to exhaustible natural resources, is one of those clauses that can be used for the environment. For consumers, raising the price of carbon-intensive products incentivizes them to drift away from such commodities towards environment-friendly products. As the regulator of international trade, the World Trade Organization should applaud these efforts and embrace them by showing everyone this approach is legal. With tax revenues gained through border carbon adjustments, national governments could look to fund innovative environmental projects for their citizens, while helping build a clean global economy. Read CG's research on border carbon adjustments by visiting cgonline.org/bordercarbon.